Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Imagine a perfect beach day. You are sitting on the sand, looking at the ocean. You reach down and grab a pile of sand and look carefully at it. What do you notice? You probably notice that there are many different components of the sand. Maybe some small rocks and shells, as well as sand of varying colors. If you put that handful down and grab another handful of sand, would it be exactly the same as the first handful? No, it wouldn't be, because every sample of sand, even on the same beach, is different, with a different combo of shells, stones, and sand. Sand is a mixture, or a physical blend, of substances. In this lesson, we will learn about mixtures and compare them to pure substances like the water molecules in the ocean. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to classify matter based on its composition, distinguish between elements, compounds, homogeneous mixtures, and heterogeneous mixtures. If you think back to a previous unit, we introduced the term matter. We defined matter as anything that has mass and takes up space. In this lesson, we are going to look at matter more closely as we classify it into two different categories: pure substances and mixtures. A pure substance is matter that has a definite and uniform composition. But what does that mean exactly? Let's break it down. Definite means certain, and uniform means the same. Think about a team uniform. When everyone wears it, they are all dressed the same. So, definite and uniform composition means certain and the same composition, which means that all samples of the substance will be exactly the same. Examples of pure substances are sugar, salt, water, and all of the elements on the periodic table. There are two categories of pure substances: elements and compounds. We spent time in a previous unit discussing elements and the periodic table. Elements are pure substances that contain only one type of atom, and, as we learned previously, they can't be chemically broken down into a simpler substance. Each element has unique properties, and every sample of the same element will have the same properties. For example, the density of mercury is 13.5 grams per milliliter, and this density remains unchanged no matter the size of the sample. Compounds, such as water and carbon monoxide, are made when two or more atoms are chemically bonded together. All samples of the same compound have the same properties. Water always boils at 100 degrees Celsius, no matter how big or small the sample. However, the properties of the compound are different from the properties of the elements that make the compound. Carbon monoxide is a clear, colorless, odorless gas that is harmful to humans. It is made of one carbon atom and one oxygen atom. Carbon as an element is a black solid, while oxygen is a gas that humans need in order to survive. But bonded together in the right ratio, they form a gas that can be deadly to humans. The properties of the elements are nothing like the properties of the compound they make when chemically bonded together. I'm so excited. I ordered the most amazing salad for lunch. It was so delicious. The only problem was that I ordered it without tomatoes, and it still had tomatoes when it came to my table. Luckily, a salad is a mixture, so it was easy enough to just pick out the tomatoes and place them on a side dish. A mixture is a physical blend of two or more substances, like a salad. The individual components of a salad are not altered in any way when they are mixed together, which makes it easy to remove the parts you don't like. These components retain their original properties. The tomato was still a tomato in my salad. Mixtures can be broken into two categories: heterogeneous mixtures and homogeneous mixtures. Heterogeneous mixtures are like my salad. They are not uniform throughout a sample, and each sample is different. If I were to divide my salad in half, the two halves would not be exactly the same. Also, if I were to order this same salad tomorrow, it would be different, even with the same ingredients. It may have more olives or cucumbers, or maybe it won't have tomatoes. Other examples of heterogeneous mixtures include sand, cookie dough, and liquids that settle upon standing, like orange juice with pulp. Homogeneous mixtures are mixtures that are uniform in composition, which means that every sample of the mixture has the same substances in the same ratio. Alloys are mixtures of metals that have an increased strength and hardness. Bronze is a mixture of copper and tin atoms in a uniform composition. Sugar water is a specific type of homogeneous mixture called a solution. A solution is a mixture formed by dissolving a solid in water. Often, it does not look like a mixture because the solid molecules, sugar molecules in this case, are so spread out from each other that they are invisible to the naked eye. One big difference between pure substances and mixtures is that mixtures can be physically separated back to their original substances. For example, pasta in water is a heterogeneous mixture, but I can easily strain the water to get the pasta all by itself again. If I have salt water, the salt is dissolved, but I can boil away the water to leave just the salt in the container. Sometimes in situations like this, where there are a lot of different categories to sort through, it is helpful to use a flowchart. When using a flowchart, you ask a series of yes and no questions to help you get through to a final choice. Let's try it with an example. What type of matter is chicken noodle soup? Starting at the top, can it be physically separated? Yes, it can. Okay, next question. Does it have a uniform composition? Well, each scoop from the pot will have a different combo of noodles, chicken, and veggies. So, no, it does not have a uniform composition. That means that our chicken noodle soup is a heterogeneous mixture. Let's work through one more example. What about baking soda dissolved in water? Can it be physically separated? Well, yes, it can. There is a process called distillation that allows us to separate out a solid that has been dissolved in water. You heat the water up to a boil so it becomes a gas, and what is left behind after all of the water becomes a gas is the solid that was dissolved. So baking soda dissolved in water is a mixture as well. Last question, does it have a uniform composition? Well, think of salt water. If you drink a glass of salt water, every sip tastes the same, right? Solutions, by definition, are uniform in composition. So, baking soda dissolved in water is a homogeneous liquid. If this is still a little unclear, don't worry. We will practice more of these in the lesson PDF. As we went through the lesson today, we learned about the different ways you can classify matter, and that all matter is either a pure substance or a mixture. In our next lesson, we will look at the different states of matter. Until next time, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. Hey, hey.